Thus, you will be seeing on your screen the course curriculum, right? This is what you must have got. So we'll start with the introduction of R, okay, the history, the features, why R, why not SAS, or what is the difference basically, okay, and what basically R has as an exclusive feature which no other statistical analysis software for that matter has, okay. And then we'll learn how to obtain and manage, you know, R, how to install packages, how to install all the different libraries, different understand different R interfaces, okay, the various R interfaces or GUIs, if you can, if you understand, okay, the graphical user interface. So we'll understand the usages, the R windows which are there on the R Studio. Now one more thing before we start, that we'll be learning everything on R Studio. There's a big reason behind it. I'll just disclose it today, okay, in a few moments. But before that, let's see. Then we'll learn functions and R programming. Now the whole course curriculum is going to be of 48 hours. Okay, so we'll be covering everything in 48 hours. Okay, that is
so
too much.
Including a statistical part as well?
Yes, yes, yes. We'll be covering everything. So then we'll be learning all the functions of R and all the features that we'll be using inside R. The functions, their arguments, how do we create an argument, what does it mean, how to debug a code if there is a problem or if there is an error. Okay. We'll understand, then we'll go into data management, because you know, for any statistics, you need to understand and you need to know what your data is and how it looks like, right? So for that, you need to understand what your data is and how you put it inside R, how you import it, how you export it, okay, changing environments of data is very, very important. So we'll learn that. We'll also learn how to, you know, cut through your data, you know, sorting your data, merging it, aggregating it, and reshaping it in all sorts and all forms. Okay, then we'll be learning about control structures, or also called as conditional statements. Okay, so we'll learn about them. Then we'll learn about how to write a user-defined function in R. Okay, that too is very important, because not all the functions of your use may be available in R. Okay, or maybe sometimes you may need to create your own function, especially in functions like apply. You need to create your own set of function. Okay, so for that we need to understand how to write a function. Okay, and then we'll learn how to do looping in R. Okay, which is the apply series. Okay, it's not it's L I, so the L is missing. Just okay, so it's apply to apply. Okay. And then we have the date and time functions, because date and times are something very, very unique. They look like character, but they are numbers. Okay, so that is the that is one challenge with date and time, and that is why we need to learn how to operate dates and times in R. Okay, Surinder, can you hear my voice now? Okay, still Surinder is not able to hear. Anyways, then we'll move towards graphical plotting. Okay, and we'll see all the plotting features, how to do all the different parameters of plotting in R, and we'll be learning the package called ggplot2 and lattice. The two very important packages in R. Now you must be thinking, what packages are? Okay, so packages are a collection of functions. Okay, for now, for your understanding, just a collection of functions. Okay, then we'll also move into the advanced plotting features in R. Okay, which includes parallelograms, combined plots, lattice graphs, ggplot graphs. Okay, so these are the advanced plotting features of R which we'll be seeing. Okay, and then we'll move towards the analytics part. After, so it's basically and functions in R, conditional statements in R. Till now I'm just you know, revising it. Okay, so conditional statements in R, then you have loops in R, user defined functions, data visualization, and finally then we'll be moving into the analytics. So the analytics part will include basically three things. Okay, so the three things are the descriptive stats, the inferential stats, and the decision stats or decision science, you call it. So the descriptive stats basically include all the concepts like mean, median, mode, standard deviation, mean deviation, all those stuff. Then we have our inferential stats, which includes probability, which includes modeling, includes correlation, so regression. So we'll be okay. I suppose probably please help out, Surinder. He is not able to listen to me.